Are you struggling to write a complicated formula inside of Airtable? Well, if so, you don't have to struggle alone because in this video, we're going to be breaking down my biggest tips for writing complex formulas. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. If you want to learn how you can start leveraging the power of no-code, the best place to start is to understand automation. How can no-code automation run those repetitive, mundane tasks that you do day in and day out, but run them all in the background so that you don't have to be bothered by them anymore? Well, if you want to learn the fundamentals of automation, check out my free training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. It's an hour-long training that will teach you the fundamentals of automation so you can get started today. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of this video. We're talking about formulas. How can you start writing a complex formula in Airtable? So let's start by hopping into my screen and we're going to look at a live example. Here we have three different fields that are going to contribute to our formula. Order status, quantity, and unit price. Before we get started writing a formula, we first need to talk through what we want the formula to do. So the formula we want to write is the amount that we've received in dollars if the thing has been paid. So you could imagine it basically saying, only if the order status is equivalent to paid, then do I want to take the quantity and multiply by the price. So it's not a terribly complicated formula, but there are multiple layers to it. And so the first place we want to start is by building a field where we're going to just put in the actual value that we want to see based on what is happening for each of these records. So I might set up a blank formula like this, and I'll just call it blank, and I'll use the single line text field. And so I'll create this field, and what I'm going to do is just write in a few of the different outputs that we expect for our formula, so that when we build the formula, we can check it back against this field that we've just created. So in this case of record one, it hasn't been paid. The order status is invoice submitted. And so we would expect nothing to be here. However, in the second case where the order is paid, we would expect the quantity times the unit price, which would be 3,000 US. Similarly, in records 3 and 4, similar to record 1, the status does not match paid, and so we would expect these to also again be blank. So now that we have this little placeholder here, we can compare our actual formula to this field, and then once we've verified that our formula is working, we can eliminate this field entirely. So now let's start with my next big tip for formula creation, and it's to take things one step at a time. A lot of times, new formula writers will start to put everything all at once in one big complicated formula, and it's really easy to get lost and make mistakes that way. So my big piece of advice here for you is to break it down into the smaller steps, and then once those small steps are working, we're going to combine those steps together to get the output we desire. So the first part is, we need to test the logic. The logic component is looking at the order status, matching to see if it is paid, if it is paid, doing something, and if it's not paid, doing something else. So we're going to build a field here. We're going to call this part one and logic. And I'm going to write a formula here, and this component is simply going to be the logical component. So I'll start with an if formula in this case. Now, when we start writing a formula in Airtable, you'll notice that we get this little helpful syntax pop-up here. And what this is telling us, if we look at the top part of this, are the parameters that need to go into this formula. So the first piece is the logical parameter. The second component is the value if the logical parameter is true. And then the third piece here is going to be the value that outputs if the logical parameter is not true. That's all broken down in the text right here. And then under that, we get an actual example. So if sales is greater than 50, then a win, otherwise lose for this example. So for us, first component is the logical piece. So we say order status. So if order status is equal to paid, two things to point out here. Number one, this has to be inside of single or double quotes because this is text. And also, we have to make sure that we're matching that syntax verbatim. So if you have a capital P in paid, as we do in our order status, that has to be matched here. So that's the first parameter here. Now we separate parameters inside of our formulas with commas, so drop a comma in. Now we have an output in the case where this is true, and then we have another output in the case where it's false. Let's use placeholders for now. I'll have a 1 if it's true, comma, 2 if it's false. So I now have all three of my parameters. First parameter is my logical equivalence test. My second parameter is the output if it's true, and the third parameter is the output if it's false. So we go ahead and create this field, and what we see should match that where the order status is equal to paid, we see 1, and everywhere that it's not paid, we see 2, as we have here. So this is the first component of our formula, and it's working perfectly. The second component now can be built in a second formula. So we'll have part 2, and this is the mathematical part. And I'll, again, build a formula field, and this one's relatively simple. All I need to do here is multiply the quantity times the unit price to come up with the total amount of that particular order. So, quantity field, here we are, multiplied by the unit price. Find that, and we're good to go. Let's go ahead and create this field, but before we do, we'll toggle into our formatting here, make sure we're in currency mode, and create the field. So here we are. We now have accurately represented the total of quantity times unit price, and we can verify that just by looking at these different outcomes here. 10 times 1500, 15,000, 5 times 600, 3,000, etc. So now we have two different formulas, but we want to consolidate them into one. And we have placeholders in our first formula that we can utilize in order to help us with this process. So in order to replace those placeholders, the 1 and 2 output that we have here, let's go first into part 2 math and just copy our formula. Select the text and copy it. Drill back into our part 1 logic formula. And where we had a 1 previously, we don't want that placeholder variable anymore. We can instead highlight that and replace it with the formula we just copied. So now if we save this up, we're going to have almost a complete formula. We have the logic calculating that if the order status is paid, then it will output 3,000. And we can see that we're matching up to our placeholder variable that we put here, the blank field that we created just as a test. So we're matching up pretty well here, with the exception of anywhere that we have order status not equal to paid, we still have this variable of 2, which again is just a placeholder. So let's drill back into part 1 logic, and we have a couple of options here. Now part 1, we can completely eliminate this third parameter. If we want to ditch it entirely, we don't actually have to have an output in the case where the logical condition is not met. So I could just delete this and move on, and we'd be just fine. The other option, though, is to instead replace the 2 output with an actual blank output. And in order to call upon a blank output, I'm just using blank, open and closed parentheses. Once I've done this, I'll go ahead and save the formula. And rather than instead having a 2 here, we now have nothing or a null value. And so we're matching perfectly now to our stand-in formula. We said we only want to see 3,000 in the case where it's paid, and that's what we show right here. So we no longer need this stand-in field. We can just delete this entirely now that we've got our formula working. Now also be sure to remove any of the extra formulas you built along the way, so I no longer need part 2 math, because all of that math now lives inside of my primary formula. I will also rename this formula to say amount received. And I'll also go into formatting to make sure that I'm getting the output desired. So in this case, currency, and we are now good to go. We can test this formula just a little by making sure that if we change the order status to paid, that then the math is calculated and we see that it was immediately done. And also if we change one of the quantities here, verify that the amount received also recalculates. This one takes just a moment longer, but there we see 2,500, we're good to go. I know we went fast in this video and covered a lot of ground, but these tips are going to help you build incredibly powerful formulas inside of Airtable, so be sure to go back and rewatch if you have any questions. I hope you got a lot out of this. If you want to see more about no-code and no-code news like this, be sure you subscribe to this channel, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program, and for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.